The first one, PD and another versus AR and another, which was a very, very interesting judgment from the KwaZulu-Natal High Court under the pen of Mossop J. You can find the judgment in your bundle at page 12 and the summary at page 2. The full citation, PD and another versus AR and another, D779-2023, and that is 2024-ZAKZDHC27. This judgment landing on the 17th of May 2024. Now, this is an interesting matter in that it dealt with an urgent application for care and contact by an interested party. Now, there... essentially, what gave rise to the litigation was that the applicants had an informal arrangement with the biological parents of a minor child who was aged 5 at the time where they had the child in their care. The informal arrangement came to an end. The respondents, being the biological parents, terminated the arrangements, prompting the applicants then to approach the court on an urgent basis to try to establish care and contact with the child, who was, as I mentioned, 5 at the time. The aspects covered under this judgment range from the rights and responsibilities of caregivers. Now, remembering caregivers is a concept which is defined in the Children's Act. And what was also interesting in this fact is that in this court was the fact that the court did not follow the family advocate's recommendation. So for those of you dealing with matters where you have a family advocate's recommendation, which you do not believe to be in the best interests of minor children, this judgment could give you some precedent, especially if you are in the KZN area. And then the essential fulcrum of this matter was that parents have the responsibility and right to regulate who their children exercise contact with. The court dismissed the application of the caregivers, ruling that the applicants had no legal entitlement to contact with the child. Furthermore, the urgency was there was not found to be any urgency in this instance. Two notable quotes, paragraphs 26 and 20 of the judgment. First one, paragraph 26, parents are entitled to regulate the lives of their children. They may determine with whom their children have contact and on what terms. And then paragraph 20, the applicants have no entitlement in law. It is not their duty to explain to the minor child why the arrangement no longer prevails. It is the function of her parents. Very, very important judgment insofar as we do see quite a lot of these section 23 and 24 matters coming up recently with third-party caregivers wanting to establish formalized contact and care arrangements. Those of you who were in the roundup last month would remember that there was that interesting Cape Town judgment with the surrogacy arrangements where there was care and contact put in place.